Hello, I am Icebeast, and welcome back. To Europa Universalis IV, I was trying to figure out where the hell this army is gone, actually. But apparently, the war. Now I remember. We were in a war with our ally, and it ended. Whew, that was dumb of me. Anyway, we are probably going to be going to war, speaking of war, with the Mamluks here. Pretty darn quickly. Let's find out what the best province is. So 6, 5, 7 at Karga, 12 in Kina. I don't think I can fabricate a claim on Kina, but let's find out. Maybe I can. No. So it's probably Kusar that we want to fabricate claims on. Then we're going to fabricate claim on probably Ras Garib. Then we're going to fabricate a claim on Asyut. And that's pretty much it. And then we're going to just, I guess we'll keep building a spy network to fabricate some more claims. But yeah, we're going to get these claims going because we will be going to war with these guys here relatively soon. I do want to come back across now. I think the Cretan rebels should be fine without my troops here for a bit. Apparently the knights have fabricated a claim on this province. The knights are allied with Venice. That is interesting. I would love to take their territory some point soon. Don't need to use my... those capabilities yet. Military tech 10, military tech 11. We are at military tech 10. So we do need to get up here with these new military techs. You are still Muslim tech group, okay? Wow, you just declared war on... you just straight up declared war on the Austrians? You really sure that's a good idea? Wow. I'm a little surprised that that just happened. Prestige is always nice, but money is, I think, a little bit better. Realize we still have the mission to get our prestige above 50, which somehow we've completely failed to do. Our power projection's been going great, but we're doing horrible with our prestige. Are the Mamluks still one of our rivals? Who the fuck are our rivals? England, Persia, and Portugal. So Persia, issue embargo, confirm. We'll need to issue an embargo against England. Let's do it. Come on. It's taking forever. What we are going to have to do is get our transport ships. We only need 4. Don't know why I just did what I just did, but we only need 4 transport ships. 1, 2, 3, 4. We're going to grab these bad boys and send them down to the colony. Because we're going to need to pick up these troops for our next colony. You guys can just come chill somewhere. We can even mothball this fleet. That would probably make sense. We got 24,000 men down here. I'm assuming these guys don't have a chance in hell for that. It's October 1560 when we need to go to war with them. We need to get to contact Alodia because we're going to want to go to war with Alodia. What the fuck's Kaffa? Oh, this is Kaffa. Okay. They're both military tech 10, which does suck for us. We'll want to get up there. We should be military tech 11 shortly, so that's at least a bonus. They're doing really good. Yeah, we're probably going to want to come here and maybe conquer all of Kike right away. Because the Portuguese are moving up here rather quickly and terrifyingly. Let's get you on the boats. This should take over here in not too long. What's this? Who's this? That's actually a country. Interesting. Alright, our colony has become self-sustaining. Hells to the yeah. That means we should be able to now... What? Are you not core? You're a core province. You're telling me this is too far fucking away? It's 384. 382. I'm a little pissed off that this is too far fucking away. 380 fucking 2? God damn it. When do we get the next idea here? This gives me a 50% range bonus, which should be enough to get us there. We'll totally be taking this. How are we doing monarch point wise? Okay, it's good that we're focusing on this for sure. So we'll be getting 9, so we're slightly under 2 months away. Oh, we're gonna have the diplomatic insult CB expiring in a minute here. Are you still allied with the Ottomans? You are. I really don't get what the heck the Ottomans are thinking, but they're gonna be losing some territory, so that's a thing. Did you guys win your war against Colombia? I actually don't have any idea. Alright, boom. Okay, so now we should be able to colonize here, right? Can we colonize up here? Oh, we totally can, and this is actually a better place to colonize. The main problem is that we have no way of getting there by boat. But we're still gonna send our colonists there. If you get on the boat, well, first if we put our this is just a regular leader. Boom, we need a conquistador. This guy, I'm sorry, you are gonna be fired. So this guy is the new leader. You get on the boat. Actually, you could just probably march all the way up to here. Why don't you just get on the boat now? I'm confused. Just get on the goddamn boat. Okay, you make sure you're still here. You get on the goddamn boat. We're gonna take the boat up to here. Very strange. 7, okay. Oh, Denmark has inherited most of their bitches. And by most, I would say all. Denmark has also taken a decent amount of the Highlands, which is interesting. Scotland is allied with Leinster. That's not going to go well. Alright, so we want to put you into the land here. Then what I want to do is grab you and have you come this way. Oh, you're just going to walk the old-fashioned way. Okay. Then we can bring this fleet back home. It's fine if you walk the old-fashioned way. You can come back here. But yeah, we definitely want to get here so that we can start conquering these guys. We already know how good it is to conquer these guys. So yeah, we're definitely going to want to do that. October of this year is when we're going to be going to war with these guys. Let's build, while we're here, we have a little bit of time. Let us build 2 cannons. This is fine. So we'll build 2 cannons to get that a little bit stronger. We're also about to get our next military tech. Yeah, we're about to get our next military tech. In fact, we're 3 away. You will arrive in 67 days and there will be troops waiting for you. And apparently just attack the natives for free. Cool. Boom. Get them muskets. Lose piety and gain manpower, or sure, just lose the fucking piety. We actually have more manpower than we needed. My general has died. Unfortunate, but fine. My colonists will arrive shortly. Cool. And once these guys will be here in a second, making this an 11-6-9, which is a really darn good army, actually. The only downside is it might be too big. Our advisor died, but not one that we care about. Our grand army causes envy, but at the moment no one seems to care. Oh, we lost the grand army causes envy ability. We gain money, they lose loyalty, which drops them to 35, and they lose influence. Or they gain I gain prestige and loyalty. We're losing money now. Is that because our colonist has started doing his business? It is. Okay. Alright, cool. Let's merge these armies and get ready for war. We are losing a little bit of money. Not 100% sure what changed, but something totally changed. Oh, our truce with the Mamluks has just ended, even though I thought it was in October, but that's okay. I'm going to declare war on you. I'm going to take... Razgareb is going to be our... No, Kisar is going to be our war goal. So we're going to come all the way down this way right away. Who are your allies? Funge and Warsangali. Okay. We just upgraded to the next tech. So we're both at 11. How are you doing so fucking good? Whatever. I should totally be putting my my conquistador on here. Because he is much better than I am, but that's okay. What I want to do is detach a couple units of infantry to run around sieging everything. Yeah, we're just going to quickly siege everything. This should help real well. Yep, just get everything sieged nice and quickly. Beautiful. Can you siege this? You can. Beautiful. Can you siege this? The answer is yes. Come on home. Oh, I know why I'm making no money. It's because my forts are active. There we go. This should turn, or at least turn partially around. Fort maintenance should drop in half, so we should, this should turn to the positive, and it did. I wonder if we're actually going to win this fight, but I'm bringing in the extra troops. Well, we're losing the prestige I don't have. Come on, those damn troops, get here a little bit faster. There we go. This will be the complete and total siege of the Mamluks accomplished pretty much instantly. And that's good for us. We've taken control of our last place. What are you fabricating claims on, England? Are you fabricating claims on my shit? My shit over here? Don't give a crap about Persia. Plus 50 settlers a year. That's actually pretty darn good. There's already 933 dudes over there. 63% war score. There we go. Let's get our... actually, the other guy's better. This guy has really good maneuver. Our king is better. There's no way we can get down here, right? Not at the moment. You have 25 supply, 20, 20. Let's at least put you down here for now while we see if we can get military access. Cool. Now let's come on down to Funge. Or Warsangali, I should say. Does Funge have access? They might. Bunnish troops aren't that threatening, though. No, go away. I want to completely and totally annex you. Boom, 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 boom. 73 war score. Just gotta give me 73 war score and you will be my bitch. God damn, everything's so goddamn expensive. Yemen and Alodia are currently at war. It's interesting. Alodia is allied with Amman and Kaffa. Oh, we ran into the army of Warsongali. Bye-bye, army of Warsongali. So we'll very quickly siege this. How many troops? Oh, we still got plenty of troops, so that's good. What's your supply limit? 16? Alright, what's your supply limit? 19? Jesus Christ. All these forces suck. I won't be able to carpet siege this until I finish sieging this, because these troops here actually will represent a problem, and we're not going doing the like crazy roundabout bullshit that the game just suggested. What? God damn it. I'm gonna have to go crush these guys. Not happy about that, but we're gonna go do it right now, actually. Not happy about having to do this, but we're gonna lose otherwise. Not lose, but they're gonna unsiege this, and that's gonna be a goddamn pain in my goddamn ass. So we'll march all the way back. It's take about 50 years. And we'll probably have to split this into two armies, actually, because of the supply limits. I don't want to be this far over the supply limits. And I probably should have done that right now while we're marching through the territories. But that's okay. We got money. We have manpower. We're losing manpower, but we have the manpower. We should just crush Funge. Like, this should be just a ridiculously one-sided battle. And it was. Alright, cool. Now that we have the actual, like, manpower to do what we want to do, we will come down this way. Oh, sweet. Free stability is the best stability. You, my friend, should come this way. Oh, I found this army. Let's go fight it. 23rd of February is when you will arrive for support. It is good to support, although you arrived too late. Oh, very close to accepting. Very close to accepting. Now you get the fuck out of here. So yeah, we're gonna completely annex or completely vassalize treaties. Not Tunisian vassals, revoke core. So if I just go like this, boom, 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 treaties. Whatever happened to a complete annexation here? Don't know whatever happened to that. I always thought there was an option for complete annexation, but it apparently has gone the way of the dodo. But once we get to 73% war score, which won't be very long, and we might actually get it just by taking Warsongali here, we'll be fine. We'll be fine. 72% war score. If they want 73. I can't believe that it's not because we've completely occupied them that we don't get more war score. But that's okay. Goddamn England and your goddamn dick status. Bunch of dicks. Yeah, I know, but you're not going to give me what I want. Oh, but we're at 73% war score, so I can just probably just take it. No, we need slightly more. We need slightly more. We're at 123 and they're at 127. We're at 124, now they're at 126. Length of war keeps changing. I'm making gains, which keeps changing. My war score is slowly going up. Their blockade is actually helping them significantly, which is kind of funny because I have no coastal capabilities here. Where the fuck are you going? Yeah, can we just bring the whole army to Harar here? Huh, come on down. Sure, fight us. Come at me, bro. Oh, damn it. We're at 74% war score. Is that enough to give me what I want? It is. We demanded their full annexation. We got their full annexation. Corruption's on the rise, because it always is. Let's first core everything, and then we'll end this episode. Start with the most important cores, then the less as important cores, and then finally cored all that. We'll have to deal with the corruption problem. Alright. That deals with the corruption problem. Now we just have to deal with the fact that we have no money. So bring the army home, and then we will lower its maintenance, which should deal with the money problem. But with that all being said, we're going to end the episode here. So thank you guys very much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it. Our next target is going to be the Americas over here, I think. I think we're going to do some conquering. Some conquering. But with that all being said, I will see you all next time.